Everybody, it's Victor. It's time to the Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance Series. Happy Saturday, Mosh Pit. I hope you're having a great start to this brand new weekend here. We did have another video cross 3,000 likes, which now only puts us at 6 away. We are on the home stretch for the keyboard tracking episode. So if you'd like to make that possible and get here a lot sooner, make sure you click that like button. Remember, we do have double like streak goal incentives as well. 6,000 likes gets us 2, 9,000 likes gets us 3, all that kind of good stuff. So thank you all very much who's been making it possible thus far. And like I said, I hope you're having a great start to your weekend. Here's your meme of the day. It just seems like, you know, whenever we have a Sumptorium episode, the memes just come out in droves. Title thread here posted by Legitimate Ear 9240. Title thread was a true love story. Yes. I'm sorry, Mega. I'm sorry, Shoop. And I'm not sorry, Flush, because you're not very good. But look, Sumptorium, it just catches my eye. You know, what can I say? What can I say? Thank you very much to Legitimate Ear and everyone who upvoted that one. Yeah, it does seem like it does, like, whenever we get a Sumptorium episode, it just breeds the memes. One tad R808. Oh, my God. What is this tiers rate? Good Lord. 1.91 tiers. Yikes. That is atrocious. We also have the Cleaver and Lard, which, oh boy. At least our damage is better than average. That's literally the only thing that's better than average here. We have not great shot speed, just god awful movement speed as you would expect from having a large start, but the biggest problem by far is going to be the 1.91 tier delay. This is really, really bad. So, unlike the Montezuma's Revenge episode, this one here, we've got a very different problem with our DPS, and it concerns with the actual fire rate itself, obviously. So, we are once again going to be looking for early secondary forms of damage. Like, this would be an episode for us to get something like Book of Shadows and an Orbital on, or... I mean, right now we need anything and everything that can just cause damage. You know, this is like these stats are so bad that pills may be an option. Like, they just might have to be an option because our stats cannot get any lower. Desperate times calls for desperate measures. And yes, I'm even talking about possibly even buying the mom's coin purse inside of the shop here, if we get one more cent, which, I mean, we can technically if we used a bomb here, but man, this is rough. This is already rough here. So the Cleaver is also not going to be much help. Unfortunately, it only really shines if you're able to use it multiple times inside the same room. You know, if we can somehow manage to get an early tiers up here, then our worries are no more. Oh my god, I have no idea what just happened there. the charm tiers definitely did their work. We had still our obligatory hit, and that is not tiers, unfortunately. It is damage, though. Damage and range. We did need a little bit of range as well. And that's just all I need to know about taking pills for the rest of this run. All right. So let's go get our half soul heart here. Unfortunately, we are not fast enough to get through the cursed room before the iframes wear off. I think the secret room is here. It pretty much has to be. This is the only place that really makes sense for it. And we get a Yave. Okay, so we can go buy another soul heart. I think we should, honestly, just because we're going to need the extra bit of extra protection here for our devil deal. Given that our movement speed is so bad and the health down kind of sucks. Let me rephrase that. We are never desperate enough to take pills without PhD or Virgo. Ever. Period, point blank, ever. All right, got it. Good. Pills suck. Just don't take pills. If we can somehow manage to get more soul hearts out of the Tinted Rock, that would be great. This is not a great matchup for us, although the charm tiers here will be nice. As long as we can charm both of them, which we obviously we just did. Because they'll just run into each other and do massive amounts of damage. There's some movement speed. We do get a troll. We do get a tower card, which we can use in this room here. Three cents and a bomb, which is not what we were looking for, unfortunately. There we go. So really, honestly, like the charm effects that we're getting out of Mom's eyeshadow are really, really strong right now. And, you know, we talk about secondary sources of damage. Look no further than that right there. I mean, you know, things running into each other and just plowing over other enemies. That is fine by me. Anything that can make the enemies just die quicker and where we don't have to fire one of our 1.91 tiers per second is that's like light speed ahead of where we can expect to be from an efficiency standpoint. And I've always said, and I'll continue to say this, bad damage will not kill you as fast as bad tiers will. Bad tiers will kill you faster than bad damage ever will. You can be doing 100 damage per shot. It doesn't matter if you're only firing once per second. It is not a good place to be. You have to have some way. If you do not have a good amount of tiers rate, you need to find an alternate source of damage immediately, because tiers rate is everything in this game. And it's not that outlandish to say. That tiers rate, I would say, is the most important stat in the game, which some people might find surprising. But again, I've seen runs, I've been on runs that have been flat out lost because I just was not able to deal enough effective damage to things or keep them away from me if they're sitting there charging me without having the knockback of our regular tiers. So, you know, this is all hands on deck. We are in crisis mode territory already, and it's just because of the extremely bad nature of the least amount of tiers that we have here. Being 1.91, anything below 2 tiers per second is god-awful. Like, anything below 3 is kind of sad, but, like, 2.5 is, like, that's pretty much average. Anything below 2 is just atrocious, especially if it's not coupled with something like a Polyphemus or an Ease Mascara where you're just doing overwhelming amounts of damage. Flipped rib to slip bad, and we are going to continue to slowly meander our way over here. At least we got a movement speed up. That is going to keep us a little bit safer, but it's not the end-all be-all, obviously. We're going to need help. And the tiers in the tiers department, the only thing that can save us right now are our boss tier effects, or boss drops, or if we somehow manage to get a good stat reroll. Actually surprised that Molly Boom didn't destroy that other spider over here. We have 19 cents, which is good enough for us to have a premium item. There you go, that's what I was counting on. Get ourselves a free key here as well. We get another tower card, moon card, death card, and lover's card. I'm going to go to the tower card. At least we can use this against the bosses, especially if we can stun them with the cleaver while they're splitting. We'll have to use the tower card and then split them, whoever it might be. So we are going to be able to get the 9-volt, which is okay. It means we can use the cleaver in every single room, but it's not a continuous charge. We need something better than that. We're going to wait for this, and then we're going to stun the monstros. We did get one, unfortunately. And we get HP. And we get this devil deal. Hoo boy. This is rough. Gonna be looking for the moon card here. We could use it on this floor, but I'd rather use it inside of a challenge room. And man, that is a disappointment here. But contract from below might help us. We'll see. So this is exactly what I'm talking about here. I'd rather use the moon card to get out of a challenge room than simply just use it for no reason at all. At least we don't have to sit there and worry about fighting in that challenge room here. So hopefully, get the tears up on this floor and we can start turning it around. We might still even be in contention for boss rush still if we're really, really lucky. No idea what these charm spiders are doing here. Do you see me use the cleaver there as a little bit of a stun? High Priestess will at least allow us to kill the, this is a good play here. It will at least allow us to kill, if not almost kill, the boss on this floor, which makes it a little bit easier for us to deal with. Not sure what happened with that little cleaver there. I don't know if the floor lickers can be turned into smaller floor lickers. Okay, well, here's the boss. We do have a tended rock here, so I'm going to try to goad the gapers into firing at it, not us. Okay, so since we're already here, I am just going to go after Fallen, unfortunately. Now, Fallen is not what we wanted to see here. Because he's not going to have a tears up unless if it's the pact, and that is like really, really reaching here. If you're wondering why I'm not using the High Priestess yet, it's because I want to wait for him to split. We can kill both of them. We do get a damage upgrade with Dark Matter and a Krampus fight. Lump of Coal will help us, but it's not the end-all be-all here. We're still highly tethered to our tears rate, or lack thereof. So, again, we're going to need a lot of help here. Check from below so far has been hooking us up pretty well, and I appreciate that. Bloody Gust. Now Bloody Gust will give us a movement speed and tears up every time we take damage on a floor. But again, it's not an end all be all here. It's not a permanent upgrade, but it does help. Greatly, in fact. So, but the only downside here now is the fact that, again, in order for us to activate this buff, we have to take damage, and that's not exactly optimal. But it's about little victories here. So, at least, at the very, very least, it's something that can help us. Now, we were able to also get options inside of the shop, which is good. Options is going to allow us to get a better choice of boss items. And given the intense need of a specific stat, this is going to be huge for us. Get a stars card here, which is nice for us because obviously we didn't want to sit there and incur another penalty. Although it would help us with Bloody Gust. We need to keep our damage up. If we're going to have crappy tiers, then we need to have good damage. An Empress card. We've got plenty of bombs. But at least the Intruder is here and going to give us a little bit of a volley. Same thing goes for Vengeful Soul. So, although our tears rate hasn't increased a whole lot, although it did go up a little bit thanks to Bloody Gust, we're still getting a little bit of this sort of volley effect here, which is definitely going to contribute to having at least a little bit of effect on our killing power, which is very important. We have an Empress card here, which we're going to be able to use against the boss. I couldn't tell which one hit us, but There goes our last Soul Heart and a Greed Fight. Now all we have for protection is this Rotten Heart that we got on floor two. Greed Fight's going to get us back to 20 cents here, but we have to go through a big room. And maintaining the Devil Deal is going to be important. You're seeing here me just sort of pushing the shots at the Psyhorphs. This allows us to stay safe while still being able to hit them because we outrange them. It'll be Old Husky. Old Husky. We don't need to use the Emperor's card against Husk. It's fairly easy. Don't get a stat at all. We do get the Queen of Hearts. Now, the Queen of Hearts might be pro here if we get a lot of procs, and then we can use the Ace of Hearts to create some Soul Hearts. I want the Hermit card. So we're going to save the Hermit card, drop it outside real quick, and then go back in and use the Ace of Hearts and hopefully get a bunch of Soul Hearts. And we got a fair bit amount. We got our HP back that we lost from the HP down. Pill on floor one. So yeah, could we look for a sacrifice room? We could, but right now we're trying to make boss rush. Curse the Maze. Again, I'm going to try to prefer to use this Hermit card to get out of a challenge room if possible. You know, there can't be a room here because there's a skinny room. So take a risk and go this side, and we get Curse the Maze, of course. Double bomb drops, I appreciate that. Again, contract below, making some big time plays. About my limit for dead ends. Okay, so we have Mama Mega. Mama Mega is going to guarantee that we're going to get inside a boss rush. So now we can take our time. It's basically a free floor, next floor. This is going to max out our Bloody Gust bonus here. Just look at the just feel the difference. Of where we're at right now versus where we were before we found that Demon Judgment. But now we've got excellent DPS and maxed out movement speed. Super Secret Room should be here. We get a Soul Heart. Okay. Adversary, this is going to be significantly easier with our tears up from Bloody Gust. And also because we're going to have the movement speed up, we can dodge a lot easier. Really no excuse for getting hit here. We'll take growth hormones for damage, and there's the pact. A permanent tears up, something that, again, that we've desperately needed since the start of this run. Okay, so now we've got some momentum going here. Still have the Bloody Gust buff that we can use for the rest of this floor, which makes it infinitely easier. We need to go to the item room. Hopefully we can get another tiers up in there. And then, you know, then we're going to start talking about being a little normalized. You know, we start looking at damage upgrades. You know, again, obviously, given the nature of this game, you don't have any control over what you actually see in the game. You know, you can wish and want for a damage upgrade all you want to, but it's not going to guarantee you get anything. But that's one thing I try to teach is that, you know, in Isaac, it's important to keep your eye on the prize. It's important to know what can help you the most out of anything else that can drop. And just having that little bit of focus will keep you away from getting tilted. Ooh. Now the Stars card, the reverse Stars card is going to remove our oldest item, which is going to be Contract from Below, which has been really helping us. But but we can use this inside of a secret room and maybe get Genesis. Or not Genesis, sorry, Death Certificate. Although Genesis would be cool too, but it's not a secret room item, unfortunately. Rock Bottom would also be fantastic for us if we can manage to swing that. So I am going to go all the way back to the secret room here. It's a risk. It is a bit of a risk because Contract from Below is fantastic, although it doesn't help us any. It doesn't help us with stats. It only helps us with item drops here. So get our last little bit of item droppage going. And we'll turn around and use the Stars card. Or no, it was. I apologize. It wasn't. It wasn't Contract from Below. It was. The Charm Tears, Mom's Eyeshadow. So we have to take this. Skinny on Mushroom is going to be huge for us. Even though it's a damage down, it's not a big damage down. But it is a maximum tears buff, and that's going to solve all the problems that we had on this run. So huge time plays there from the Stars card, that reverse Stars card, which we got only from this Demon Judgment. So thank you, Demon Judgment. Appreciate it. Thanks for not being garbage for once. We're finally ready to head on down. I take Black Powder, but meh. Now we get to use Mama Mega. You see here, even after we lose the Bloody Gust buff, we still have five tiers rate, which is the soft cap of any tiers rate. So this is a, you know, you're going to see a marked difference over what we were just going through versus now. The quarter here. Huge, huge, huge swing on that last floor. Omega is just going to destroy everything on the floor. Also open up all of our secret rooms. It is going to destroy our donation machine, which kind of sucks, but what can he do? I am going to take Jar of Flies. There's just no reason not to. And we also get the Emperor card here. So we're still going to take the Fool card, however, first. Because the Fool card gets us out of Boss Rush. Even though we want to do Boss Rush, we don't necessarily want to do Boss Rush, if that makes sense. Mama Meg is also an excellent way to find crawl spaces. You have to wait for all the mobs to be dead. Although I think she did kill everything in there. Another Fool card for some odd reason. The big time plays here on this Saturday. Mongo Baby's a bro. I've got no problem with Mongo Baby. And that is a disappointing boss rush, as has been par for the course lately, but there we go. You see Jar of Flies maxing out pretty much instantaneously. We're going to go back down here and go grab this Emperor card. You didn't get a devil deal. I don't know if Mom actually died or not. I don't think she did. Soul of Apollyon. Yeah, so this, again, this was just an absolutely massive turn for us on that last floor. And now we're in a position to really start dominating. And Mom did not die, so we don't know if we're going to get a devil deal or not yet. Of course, the war flies blow up on us. I'm going to take the damage upgrade because we're going to need it. We didn't get a damage. We did not get a devil deal, but we are going to get item rooms on the next floor because we have the Bloody Crown. And Curse the Blind. Double horse pill is kind of weird. Bro, I'm glad that your eye is, like, doing so, like, some blocking training, but if you could just die, that'd be great. We still need damage. Again, obviously, we're not looking at overwhelming damage here. But again, comparatively speaking, where we were 10 minutes ago, Skinny on Mushroom completely changed the game for us. But we would not have even gotten that Skinny on Mushroom had it not been for that Stars card, which we got from the Demon Judgment. And that was only because we had enough Red Hearts to do it with. So, you know, and that was only because of there being some pretty crap Devil Deals. So, again, it's really weird and funny how Isaac ends up working out. You know, everything is connected to one another. It's a symbiotic relationship between all the bad and the good in the game. You know, you're going to find yourself having, you know, getting blessings in disguise, I would say, is the best term for it. But there's also some runs that the game just gives you a giant middle finger, just doesn't want you to play anymore, which is, you know, fine. We go into the dice room here. It's going to be a global D-sizzle. Really no reason to use that because we have no idea what's going to be inside of this item room. We really shouldn't be taking it, but I'll make a deal. If the item room's on the way to the boss here, I'll take it. But if it's not, I'm not going to take it. It's a great opportunity for us to farm some flies here. As long as they don't go plowing into the eggies. Which most of them did. Jar flies, by the way, will spawn blue attack flies every time that we kill an enemy with our tears. But it is not self-perpetuating in that the flies cannot spawn more flies. Although that would be cool. It would be neat to have like just a factory of flies. It doesn't work like that, unfortunately. So Teratoma goes down like a sack of potatoes. We get toothpicks. No. We cannot. Azel's Rage is also pretty doo-doo. This is dangerous now because we are only sitting at 3 HP and we have not seen any real good way to create more. We have to hope that Contract from Lodge starts going ham on the Soul Heart drops. Or Hybrid Heart drops. But our saving grace is going to be this Emperor card. Should we make it to the Dark Chest, which I'm hoping that we do. You just never know, man. Like, Shoal is always a crapshoot. You just have no idea what kind of mood Stanley's in. Money. HP, we pretty much have to take this. We do have a full swarm, so we've got some protection from projectiles, and we also have contact, which is going to allow us to shoot down enemy projectiles. So as long as we don't get hit with anything that we can't block, should be Gucci. Isaac is glowing because Azazel's Rage is about to go off and show you why it's bad. There you go. That was 3 Soul Hearts, everybody. How would I improve Azazel's Rage? I would allow you to store the charge and then unleash them all at once. Like a mega ultra brimstone. It can grow to the size of the brimstone from Old Beastie. That's what would make Azazel's Rage a lot better, is if you could store the charge. Because, like, it's so unpredictable. You just don't... Unless if you have the treasure map and the compass and you just know... Like, if you're going to take the time to sit there and count how many rooms it's going to take you to clear from one end to the other, just to time it to where you're going to have the Azazel's Rage proc on the boss, which I don't. If you do, hey, more power to you, but, you know... That's even then, that level of dedication is almost ridiculous for an item that doesn't really do a whole lot of damage in the first place. a game. I'd love to see like an actual soul heart for once out of these tinted rocks, because we have gotten literally none in the three or four soul hearts that we've gotten on this run. So yeah, you could just go ahead and give us that. That'd be great. Still looking for our item room here. We finally find it. And yeah. Would have loved to have seen a fortune-telling machine in there for some soul hearts, but it just ain't in the cards today. So, ironically, we are going to have a charge of Azazel's Rage for Mom's Heart. There it goes. This is where the shielded tier kind of fails a little bit against mobs that have a lot of projectiles. No devil deal, unfortunately, and we've got a long trek through Shoal, so hold on to your butts. Those of you who are fans of the Struggle Bus episodes, we've had no shortage of them this week, that's for sure. I think comparatively, out of the struggle ones that we've had this week, the Montezuma's Revenge one was definitely... That one felt more painful. This one was more painful at the start, but we were able to overcome the bad really fairly quickly. Fairly quickly, I would say. Montezuma's Revenge is always it's one of my favorite items, but it is dangerous to use. And it's always a little bit of a nerve-wracking use as well. Okay, the north side of the map, everybody. Just in case you're curious. Let's go check out the east side. Or inevitably going to the south side. This is why you hold on to Emperor cards, though. I know I get criticized for loving Emperor cards so much, and some people don't like it because... Like, oh, you just skipped the entire... You're skipping the entire level. It's like, yeah, that's the whole point there, bro. The whole point. When you're on death's door, you don't want to have to go through an entire level on like, 1 HP. No thanks. I think I'll pass. The random soul heart. We've gotten more soul hearts at random than we have out of tinted rocks in this episode. Hoping for a red heart. Not get one. A little bit weird that Blorb like did like a little bunt, a balking maneuver. Okay, I'd really love to find a red heart to fill this bone heart before we go fight Stanley, but I'm just gonna go send it here. Remember, we're only going to get stronger every time we get hit, but that doesn't mean that we want to get hit. We can sit here and squab with Stanley because we've got the anti projectile on lockdown. Do not want to lose this bone heart. I don't know what was going on with that little delay there, but that threw a whole lot of stuff off. All right. If we get a half heart, that's totally fine. We have the Emperor card ready to go. And these are going to have to be some primo devil deal items in order for me to consider them. And they are not. Gimpy is good. Gimpy's good enough to take. Everything else is not. All right, this is going to be a little bit scary, a little bit sketch here. Oh, Mongo Baby, I'm happy you're here, bro. Needed to pick me up on this run. Fortunately, we cannot stop those projectiles. We can stop these projectiles. Unfortunately, we don't have the charm tears from Mom's eyeshadow. As Sissy's shown us against Lamb, it's extremely effective at controlling him. Got some pretty easy patterns, though, thankfully. Again, Shielded Tears just kind of going toe-to-toe with Lamb. Almost run out of all of his swarm. Do not know how we've managed to DPS them down so evenly, but there we go. No hit on Lamb. Whew. All right, we did it. Let's see if the victory lap's any better. I can see Charlie Tango Hotel 318 Papa Delta. Yeah, that was tough, man. That was not a gimme win at all. And I mean, technically we haven't won because we're doing a victory lap, obviously, but you know, the big MVP honestly goes to the Demon Judgment. Goes to the Demon Judgment and Bad Devil Deals, because we would not have had the HP enough to get that that reverse stars card. Oh my god, we got a soul heart. It's a Birthmas miracle. So, hopes and dreams now for this victory lap. Damage, damage, damage. We've got Tears Rate. Flying would also be kind of nice, but we want just mega damage. Just tons of damage. So much damage we can't even see our elbows. I don't even know what that means, but my brain signed and paid for it, so figured, you know what? I'll sponsor it. That's fine. Old Dookie's old daddy. And Mr. Dolly gives us, I mean, Sty is damaged, but this gives us more HP, which we're going to need for the Devil Deal. And Azazel's Rage is ready to go. As you see there, it doesn't even last through the room, so. It's one of the more underwhelming Devil Deal items that was introduced in Repentance. Oh, so long ago. Coming up on 3 years. We're over 3 years now for Repentance. Hard to believe. Yeah, I'm just going to take... We're not getting Tears Ups here. I'm just taking it for the Soul Hearts. Back and take a look at our shop, and we gotta go find our item room. I have no idea how that fly manages to get through the swarm. Get another booster pack. Another Ace of Hearts, Judgment, Emperor card. We'll take the Emperor card. I'll always take an Emperor card. I'm actually gonna take both of the pills. Excuse me. And drop them in here, then use the Ace of Hearts to try to get more Soul Hearts, or just get nothing. That's fine too.
We got ourselves a bloody crown, we do.
More money. Money equals power would be great, of course, but any damage upgrade we can get is primo right now. We've only gotten four damage upgrades. Jesus Juice, Growth Hormones, the Pact, and another one I'm missing. Pact, Growth Hormones, Jesus Juice. Oh, that's it. There's only three. Yeah, so there's only three actual damage upgrades that we've gotten. So we're definitely due for a strong one. The room should be up here. This rage is still ready to go off. Azazel's Rage only activates if there's combat in the room that you're in. I don't know if it's going to activate in a challenge room. Yeah, it's just gonna flash for this, and that's fine. You get Guppy's Eye, which is a Guppy item, obviously, and also going to show us exactly what's inside of chests and whatnot before we actually open them. Ultra Pride, Ultra Dead. Yeah, I will take the Eternal D Sizzle. Why not? Money equals power. Let's go. You know, when you can call him, you can call him. Money equals power is going to give us damage corresponding with the amount of money that we're holding on to. Obviously, the Eternal D6, a little bit of a sketchy item because it can remove your item pedestals. Which is not great. By the way, we also got the Beelzebub transformation, which is the reason why we have flying now, in case you were curious about that. I mean, there's a reason why I don't like the Eternal D6. It is a D6 that you can use with a two-room cooldown. Obviously, it's the one that the Lost starts with, but the Loss, like, it's one of those items that, like, you don't want to use on an item that's too good to lose. You know, even if it's a mediocre item, like, we wouldn't want to necessarily lose, like, the Intruder, you know, because it's like, well, the Intruder's, I would love to reroll something, but at the same time, it's like, it's extra tears, it's extra damage. Big charge, baby. We're not going to take anything else in here because we don't want to lower our damage thanks to Money Equals Power, but it is going to help us out having multiple rerolls with the Eternal D6. But of course, that also just doubles the chance that we're going to, like, lose the item. But, you know, that's for someone with Sinvicta luck. That's not us. No. Ursa Blind. Kind of makes the decision for us on this floor here. Piercing shots and spectral tears would definitely be nice right now. Especially with the ridiculousness that was going on in that last room. You know, whenever you have piercing shots with shielded tears, it is especially nice. Because then you don't have to worry about your tears being impeded by the enemy's tears, and you can still get them. You can still get the shielded tear goodness. Dime's going to be a lot of damage here. 0.32 damage total. Definitely loving that. Beelzebub helping us out with the Pooter shooting up Husk. Get another HP on him. And Pentagram. Hey, that worked out okay. Not expecting that, but we'll definitely take it. Eternal D Sizzle hooking us up fat. Now, whatever it was before, obviously we have no idea. Got all these enchanted flies here, courtesy of Beelzebub. Not so sad that the bomb fly is dead. It can and frequently will hit you if you're not careful. Pickle back there. We definitely need to go back and get that. Little Brimmy. You can take a little Brimmy. He's not the greatest help here for us, but you know, he's okay. Take a Soul Heart. Definitely want the movement speed upgrade as well as the slowing. We can just bomb our way out of here. Saw a couple days ago. I don't remember where I read it at. May have been on Reddit, actually. The headline was, after 27 years, Sum 41 is deciding to disband. And the first and only thought in my brain was, I didn't know that Sum 41 was still a band. Like, apologies to all you Sum 41 fans out there, but I honestly did not know that they were still going. And it surprised me even more to think that they've been going for 27 years. So I was like, oh no, not Sum 41. Good God, no. Now I've successfully alienated the three Sum 41 fans out there. They only had one song that I was like kind of okay with, and that was the Hell song. Hell song is great. There's another song. It was on the Godzilla Final War soundtrack. I don't remember. Oh, We're All to Blame. That song was okay. Hell song and We're All to Blame. Those were the only two songs that like I could name by Sum 41 and be like, yeah, I'll listen to this song if there's nothing else on. Oh, you're just eating up all these HP upgrades here, D-Sizzle. I don't know if that makes me a jerk or not, but I was just like, I was surprised. I was like, I thought that they were a band a long time ago, let alone still been together for 27 years. That whole era of music, I wasn't into much of anything. It was just Metallica, Alice in Chains, Machine Head, you know, System of a Down. Like, I never got into like that early punk. Well, I guess it'd be like late 90s punk phase, you know, where the like people were listening to Blink 182. Like, I never liked Blink 182. I'm not a punk fan. What can I say? I knows what I likes and I knows what I don't. And punk has never been on the radar for me as a like, oh man, this is great. I think it's mostly to do with just like probably the vocals delivery from punk music. I'm just not a big fan of ska as well. I'm just like, it reminds me a little bit of jazz in not a good way. And I mean that because like, I'm not a jazz fan either. You know, like there's a certain level. I don't know. It's hard for me to describe. There's a way that punk delivery, like vocals are delivered that remind me of also like old timey jazz or big band vocals, you know, like over the top. It feels a little bit campy and like, I'm just like, I can't get into this. I know my friend HC Justin is a big punk fan, and you know, I've heard the punks, I've heard that stuff, and I'm just like, I just can't get into it. I've tried, really tried hard. The closest to punk that I'd say that I was into would be like Green Day. And I was only kind of digging, like, you know, their album. Green Day's got a couple of pretty good songs, I would say, that are classics. I think it's fair. 73% Devil Deal. There's piercing shots, but it's not good enough to do an entire boss rush for, in my opinion. Now, we could have gone and looked for the full card. That is true. We could have gone for it, but being lazy. I'd say it's fair that Green Day has a couple of songs that are classics. Basket Case is probably their most memorable. For me anyway, that's the song that I associate most. Anything off of Dookie is going to be like the most memorable, because that's the only Green Day album that I ever owned. I mean, just the name of the album is Dookie. I mean, how much more punk can you get? Dookie. now. But like I was too much into Metallica, I was too much into the Offspring and to really care about like other stuff from that era. Head of the Keeper was there, but I bet it's probably lying to us. That was a Rainbow Champion. The Rainbow Diglett. No, it's not. Just kidding. Alge's. Use this Alge's room just to get out of the room so we don't incur any damage penalty. Although, again, it's a little bit counterintuitive with us having Bloody Gust, but I think it's safe to say that we're going to win this run. We're going to be just fine. We were able to weather the early storm there with having just absolutely atrocious tears rate. And, you know, again, I don't want to pull the, like, you know, this is what I'm talking about card, but this is what I'm talking about. Like, being able to understand what you need, keep focused on the task at hand. We need to get tears rate. If we can't get tears right, then we need to understand what is the next point of strategy for us to take if we don't get significant tears ups. And we were planning for secondary damage. We were talking about Jar of Flies, you know, that sort of thing. So it really is important to stay focused on what you need. I'm not talking about like, oh, you can manifest whatever you need. Like, nah, don't buy into that crap. All I'm saying is that this is what I'm talking about when you say, hey, what do we need? We got what we need. We're okay here. I don't think the Eternal D6 has rolled anything positive for us on a boss roll. Okay, there we go. Well, Eternal D6, at least you tried. That's all that we can really ask for from you. But we do get 9 lives, which is our second Guppy item. Some Victor robes here, which is another huge, huge damage up. Last eye is going to be another nice damage up here. That's all Tendon Rock. Also got a Thame. Thame obviously going to be huge for us as well. You know, it's not like talking about strategies like in StarCraft or something where like you are in control of everything. Since this game is all RNG, like there's only a certain level of wishing that you can do. But the same principle still lies in Isaac as it does in StarCraft, which is just having a focused game plan. This is what we do if this happens. This is what we do if this does not happen. And you will find yourself really staying motivated and encouraged. Just through your own confidence. And you'll see your win rate go up because of that boost of confidence. Because you've got a game plan. It's fun to have a task. It's fun to know, like, hey, this is what we need, you know? And maybe we won't be able to execute it to 100% perfection. But if we don't, at least we know what the contingency is. We're not just kind of floundering. We give ourselves a plan, a battle plan. In Isaac. Shame. Well, the item pedestal still did remain inside the secret room, so maybe we'll get some help. Black Lotus would have been real nice. We needed the HP, which we don't. Haven't needed HP for a while on this run. You saw Junior. I'm willing to take a stab with Esau Jr. What we got going on here? 21 damage. Oh my goodness. So Esau Jr. is a totally separate character from Eden that we can switch to now. Esau Jr. actually has a treasure map as well as piercing shots. Because it's Dead Onion. And Little Horn too. Oh my goodness. Cricket's Head. Esau Jr. bringing the big stick here. I am going to switch back to Eden, though. Get Death's Touch. Just for the piercing shots, because we have shielded tears, etc., etc. But what's great about Esau Jr. is that you are able to kind of... how does that work, Jamie? How did a bomb that we placed behind us get propelled in front of us? Isaac Clown physics. You can really strategically use Esau Jr. to your advantage and essentially have two extra... Or have extra life, essentially, against a boss if you have a full charge on the active item. And what's so nice about Esau Jr. is that you don't get the items until you use it for the first time. So all the items that we got in Eden, they were given to Esau Jr. like end game levels of the amount of items that we have here, because that was the first time that we've actually seen and used that item on this run. Does that make sense? So like if we get 20 items on Eden and then swap over for the first time with Esau Jr., he'll also have 20 items, which is a lot better than like saying starting with Esau Jr. and then like getting two boss items and then switching over. And the items that Esau Jr. gets, they are not tied to whatever the other Isaac had. Two of diamonds. Here, just max out our money real quick. Actually, gonna switch to Esau Jr. He's got the treasure map. Oh, I didn't even see that blue fire there because this freaking bony was so small. Okay. So essentially, you could start the fight as Esau Jr. and then switch to Isaac, or you know, whoever you were playing, and effectively have two health bars, along with like totally different builds, which is really, really cool. It's a really neat item. Esau Jr. is deceptively powerful, and it has won us a couple runs before when we needed that extra life. Yeah, this is what we're talking about with the piercing shots here, just bullying Isaac, bullying any enemy that has a projectile based pain attack, and they're just totally helpless. So that is we ended up getting ourselves the dub here, and I'll take it. It was a little bit of a struggle early on. Again, I don't feel that it was as struggling as the Montezuma's Revenge episode was, but this one was rough at the start, I will say. So thank you for watching, everyone. Remember, we'd love to get this video over 3,000 likes or more. We're only 6 away now from the like streak goal of the keyboard tracking episode. I'd love to hit it before next weekend so we can do it on Sunday. So please hit that like button. Also, subscribe if you're not already a member here in the Mosh Pit. If you want to support my channel and these daily Isaac runs here, I really would appreciate it. Have a great start to your Saturday, everybody. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Avery, Missy, and Katoryu. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of the Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.